In today's video, we're going to be having a look at the new Tuya integration for Home Assistant. We're going to be having a look at some of the new features and what you can expect from the new integration, and I'll also be running through the setup and install of the beta. Check it out. What's going on, guys? I hope you're all doing well. A lot of you will have seen or heard about the new Tuya integration from a tweet that Home Assistant shared the other day. In that tweet, it mentioned that Home Assistant had been in talks with Tuya in regards to getting their new integration moved from a custom component and getting it turned into a full-fledged integration. This new integration's been kicking around for a couple of months now, and it's gone through a couple of changes since it originally launched. I've actually been in talks with Tuya and the Tuya developers, and I've been testing out and using this integration for a little while now. Now, this video was originally supposed to come out the other week, but I ran into a bug with the integration, and until that bug was fixed, I didn't want to release this video. And version 1.3 of the integration just released this week, and it fixed that bug and also added a ton of new features. Okay, so why don't we start with what this thing actually is? If you didn't already guess, this thing is the new Tuya integration. One of the key features about this integration is it's built using Tuya's new open API, whereas the existing Tuya integration is built on the old API technology. Utilizing the new API allows the integration to support more devices that were previously not supportable in the old integration. It also offers better response times, which are now measured in milliseconds as opposed to seconds, and it uses Tuya's latest security in order to help secure your account. And probably the best feature, which I know most Home Assistant users are going to love, is local control. Now, hold your horses before you go rushing off installing an integration, expecting every single device to work and expecting local control. The important thing to note is that this integration is in beta. Local control isn't currently in the integration, but it is a feature that's planned and the Tuya developers will be working on it. If you're interested in checking out what devices are now supported by the integration, I'll have a link to the supported device category page, which can be found on the Tuya GitHub in the description below. On this page, you can find all the supported devices and you can find out what version that they actually became available. And in that list just here, we can see that the robot vacuum became available in version 1.3. And I think you can probably tell by just looking at this list, especially if you compare it to the current integration, there's now lots of different supported devices and there's plans to add more and more as time goes on. In addition to adding support for the robot vac in version 1.3, they also added support for pet water feeders, the thermostat, and fixed a few other issues that had been knocking around in the other versions. So lots more supported devices with plans to add more as time goes on. This integration should also be able to control any of the Powered by Tuya devices. Powered by Tuya devices can usually be identified by the Tuya or the Powered by Tuya sticker on the outside packaging of smart home devices. And if you saw the Home Assistant tweet, you'll know that Home Assistant and Tuya have now been in talks in regards to getting this integration put into the Home Assistant integration list. And this is going to be great for Home Assistant and Tuya users because the Tuya integration will be able to make use of native Home Assistant features, and also the actual install process for the integration is going to be simplified. You won't have to download it through Hacs and go through a clunky setup. You'll be able to access it directly from the Home Assistant official integrations list. For those of you that follow me on my other social media platforms, you'll have seen that I shared a post the other day where I combined. That word, I got a bunch of different questions and information regarding this integration and I put it all together. I also asked you guys if you had any questions that you wanted me to ask Tuya, so there's a couple of those questions and answers in there too. And if you're interested in following me on those other social media platforms, there'll be links for them in the description below. And while you're down there checking those out, if you're not already, hit that subscribe button and ding dong the notification bell. You'll then be alerted to any future video that I do. My information for the answers to these questions comes directly from my contacts at Tuya and also the Tuya developers. So we're going to quickly run through those questions and answers, and then we'll follow that up with how you can go about installing and setting up this beta. And as always, this video will be chaptered, so if there's a specific question you want to hear the answer to, then be sure to make use of those timestamps in the description below. Okay then, question one. Who's making the integration? We did briefly touch on this. The integration is going to be maintained by the Tuya developer team, and Home Assistant are going to help Tuya with getting the integration shipshape and ready to be integrated into Home Assistant. Question two, what can we expect from this integration? Again, we did briefly touch on this, so you can expect more supported devices, quicker response times, eventually local support. And one that I didn't yet mention is auto discovery. So when you actually add the integration, it should be able to detect Tuya devices that are on your network and you should be able to add them in. Question three, when can I get this integration? This integration is available now, but again, the important thing to note is it is in beta, so don't expect it to be absolutely flawless. You can install the integration through Hacs, so if you stick around or skip ahead, I'll be showing you how you go about doing that. Question 4. Do I need to uninstall Tuya? So with this one, I'm assuming you mean the current Tuya integration, in which case, no you don't. Both integrations can coexist. So you can be running both the existing Tuya integration and the new Tuya integration, both at the same time. And I would recommend doing this rather than just jumping straight into the beta, because again, it is a beta. So if you've got a ton of different Tuya devices and they all suddenly start acting up, then you're probably gonna be a little bit sad. One thing to note is that if you're using both integrations at the same time, they can cause each other to go out of sync. And I think this is because they're on different APIs. So if you turn a light on one, it's not gonna update the light on the other one. So just bear that in mind if you're creating scripts and automations using both integrations. Question 5. How can I contribute to the integration? Absolutely anyone can contribute to the development of the integration. You don't need to be a crazy coding wizard or a mad Tuya API god. All you really need to do is just install the beta and have a play around with it. While you're having a play around with it, if you notice things aren't working as they should, or you think of features that are missing and you'd like to see added, you just need to report these things to the Tuya developers. To do this, you're just gonna head over to the GitHub page and you're gonna create an issue. So at the top here, we're gonna press issues. And if you had a particular issue with something not working or a particular feature you wanna see added, you're just gonna press that new issue button. And then you're just gonna populate that issue with whatever problem you ran into or a new feature that you wanna see added, and just give the developers as much information as you can. It's always best practice to first check through the reported issues to see if somebody else has already reported something similar to you. That way you're not creating a duplicate issue and you might be able to provide more information on that issue with details from your own Home Assistant. The developers are very active and responsive with these issues. So we can see here, I actually created an issue with the robot vacuum not working. So when 1.3 initially released, there was an issue with the robot vacuum not working correctly. And I created an issue for this, and you can see that information just there. And within about half an hour or so, the Tuya developers had got back in touch with me and they'd actually resolved my problem. There is still an issue with the robot vacuum where it's stuck in the cleaning state, and the actual developers are actually waiting for me to give them some information. So I'm sorry about that, guys. I'll actually get around to this as soon as I finish this video. And I think you get the idea with that. So the more people that try out the beta and have a play around with it, the more issues and problems can be found and fixed, and that way we're going to get a better integration created overall. Number 6. My device isn't in the supported list. If it's a device you absolutely love, then create an issue and make the developers aware, and that way they'll know to add it into the integration. Just as a quick note, which also refers to the previous two questions, I'm going to be putting together a video with the help of the Tuya developers, which will give you a guide on how to actually report an issue and what information to include. That way you'll be able to quickly and easily set up an issue and the Tuya developers will get all the information that they'll need. Back to the questions then, with question 7. Do I have to use the integration now? You currently don't have to use the beta integration, but the existing Tuya integration is no longer being maintained or developed, and it's actually going to be removed from the integration listing in about 5 months' time. Hopefully by then, this new integration will be a proper official Home Assistant integration, and you won't have to install it through Hacs, and it'll just be a simple and smooth transition. And if you want the specific date for when the existing integration is going to be scrapped, it's December 31st, 2021. Question 8. Do you work for Tuya? Question 9. What about Local Tuya? If you don't know what Local Tuya is, I've created a bunch of different videos on this, but essentially it's a third-party integration that's going to give you local control of your Tuya devices. As Local Tuya makes use of the old API, I imagine it's also not going to work in about 5 months' time. But hopefully by the time we reach that December 31st endpoint, the new Tuya integration will have hopefully already implemented local control. So you won't even need to use Local Tuya anymore. You'll be able to do it all through this one integration, which I know, again, might make you a little bit sad if you've spent ages adding 30 or 40 different Local Tuya devices. Okay, question 10. What about Tasmota and Tuya Convert? These processes require flashing your devices with custom firmware, and this process usually involves either dismembering or soldering parts of your device. This isn't everyone's cup of tea, but the trade-off is you're going to get full local control and get your devices out of the cloud. So I guess if you're doing those processes, you're not going to be using this integration anyway. Another thing to note is that both of these methods are not supported by Tuya. They directly conflict with Tuya's business model, and any issues caused by modification or corruption are down to you, the user. Okay, question 11, and I'm gonna stop counting now because I haven't got that many fingers. What about Zigbee and IR devices? There are plans for controlling Zigbee gateways and the devices connected to those gateways, but there's currently no plans at all for IR devices. And speaking of plans, here's a sneak peek at the Q3 roadmap for the integration. So on there, we can see we've got things like local support and getting the integration merged into Home Assistant. We've then also got things on there like auto discovery for devices that support the Tuya integration. There's going to be an improvement to the Home Assistant powered by Tuya product driver tutorial, and also more products being supported. We're going to get an FAQ for error codes and an improved login process, which is going to remove that region and country code setting. And finally, there's going to be more sections on the GitHub wiki, which is going to house tutorials and a section for voting on features. Now, there's no dates attached to those things, but that's a little sneak peek at what you can expect to see in the coming weeks and months for this integration. And the last question then, which is going to segue us nicely to the end of the video, is how do I set up and install the beta? To get started, you're going to have first needed to register for a Tuya developer account. You're then also going to have needed to register either your Tuya or Smart Life apps to your developer account. Now, in this video, I'm not actually going to be going through the process of how you do that, as I've covered that in a couple of other videos. And in a recent video I did on the Tuya API, I actually ran through this process step by step. So if you're interested in how to do that, then check that video out and then come back here. And if you're carrying on, I'm going to be assuming that you've done all this and you're ready to go. So let's jump over to our Home Assistant dashboard and get started. Okay, so we're here on our Home Assistant dashboard, but in order to get the new Tuya integration added on, we're going to first needed to set up and install Hacs. If you haven't got Hacs and have no idea what it is, I created a handy video where I went through 5 add-ons for beginners, and one of those add-ons is Hacs, so check that video out, go and install Hacs and then come back here. And if you've got Hacs installed, then you're good to go. So in the left-hand menu there, we're going to navigate to Hacs, and then from here, we're going to head into Integrations. We then want to choose the 3 dots in the top right corner, and we're going to press Custom Repositories. From here, it's going to ask us to add the custom repository URL. So we're going to paste in the new Tuya integration URL, and you can find that in the description below. For the category dropdown, we're going to choose integration, and we're just going to press add. You should then see that appear in your custom repos list, and we can close that down. We then want to press this blue explore and add repositories button in the bottom right corner. And from here, we're going to start typing Tuya, and we should see the Tuya V2 integration appear. So we're just going to press that. And then from here, we're going to choose install this repository in Hacs. And at the time of recording this, the latest version is version 1.3. So we're just going to hit install. Once that's installed, we'll see the integration in our Hacs list, and it's going to tell us that it's pending a restart. So we're just going to reboot Home Assistant now. And once Home Assistant comes back to life, we're going to head into our integrations. So I'm going to choose configurations and integrations. From the integrations page, we're going to choose add integration in the bottom right. And then we're going to search for our new Tuya integration. So in search integrations, we're going to start typing Tuya, and we should see the Tuya V2. We then just need to give that a minute to install the integration. Once that's done, we're going to just need to quickly configure the integration. So for the drop down here, we're going to want to make sure that the Tuya Cloud project is set to Smart Home Pass. And I think it now does that by default. So if yours does, just hit submit. We now just need to provide the integration with some of our Tuya details. So let's go ahead and do this now. We're going to start off with the availability zone. You're going to need to set this zone or region to be the same as whatever your Tuya or Smart Life account is registered as. So for me, I'm in the UK. So in the drop down here, I'm going to choose Europe. It's then going to ask us for an access ID and an access secret, and we can get both of these from the Tuya developer page. Over on the developer pages then, or the IoT platform, we're going to choose cloud in the left hand menu here, and we're going to choose development. Once that's open, you should see any projects that you've created, and you're going to want to choose your project and make sure that the development method is set as Smart Home Pass. So I've got my Tuya V2 one here, so I'm just going to press that. From here, we can see our access ID and our access secret, and we can just copy these and paste them into the respective boxes. So let's do that now. With both of those pasted in, we're going to need to set our mobile app. So from here, you're going to want to choose either Tuya or Smart Life, so whichever one you've registered all your devices to. In my case, it's Smart Life. Next up, we're going to need to set our country code. If you're not sure what your country code is, I'd recommend using a website like countrycode.org, where you can just pick your country and it will actually show you in a big blue box what your country code is. So from that, I know that mine's +44, so I'm just going to type +44 in there. And finally, we're going to just need to enter our account information for our Tuya or Smart Life account. So this will be the account that you've got all of your devices registered to. And with all that information entered, we're going to just press submit. And you should then hopefully see a success message. And from here, you can see all of your different Tuya devices and you can assign them to areas if you want to. A quick tip, if you're seeing this invalid authentication method and you're 100% sure that all of your details are correct, on the country code, make sure you add that plus because it seems to be sensitive to whether that plus is there or not. Hopefully that saved somebody a headache. If it did, then drop me a like. In the future, this whole process is going to be changed and it's going to be made simpler and easier to use. I'm happy with that, so I'm just going to press finish. And from here, I can now see my new Tuya V2 integration. Now, it hasn't got a logo and I'm not sure if that's just a cache issue with my browser or if the logo isn't working in the integration. So on that integration, I can see I've got 15 devices and 15 entities. If I just press on that, that's going to show me a list of all my different Tuya devices. So I can see my blinds there, I can see all my different lights, and most importantly, I can see my robot vacuum here. So let's just click on the robot vacuum and see what that looks like. As I mentioned earlier, there is still an issue with the robot vacuum where it's reporting its status as cleaning, even if it's at the dock or it's stopped moving. I imagine this one's going to just be a simple fix, but it's nothing detrimental to the robot and it doesn't affect its operation at all. So if I was to click on that and click onto the information about the robot, I can see there it's battery level. I've got the option to play, which is going to send it out and make it clean. I can stop it or I can return it to the dock. So if we jump back to our device list and choose a different device, let's go for something simple. We'll go for a light. So I'm going to choose light 3 there. So I can see the light there and it's got its toggle. So if I toggle this on, it's going to turn the light on. And if I toggle it off, it's going to turn it off. And there we go, guys. That's the new Tuya integration. So we've had a look at what's currently available and what's upcoming. And we've also had a look at how you go about installing the beta if you choose to use it. Let me know in the comments below what features you're most looking forward to. Before I go, I want to just say a big thank you to the Tuya developers for the work that you're doing at the minute. And an even bigger thank you to these awesome dudes. These awesome dudes are my Patreons. If you're interested in supporting my channel and becoming one of these awesome dudes, then there'll be a link to my Patreon in the description below. If you've enjoyed this video or found it informative, then don't forget to drop me a like rating. And if you're new around here, feel free to hit that subscribe button and ding dong the notification bell. You'll then be alerted to any future video that I do. If you're stuck and running into issues, feel free to head on over to my Facebook group where myself and others can further assist you. If you're having a problem that's Tuya related, then head on over to the Tuya GitHub page, which is linked in the description below, and open up an issue there. If you want to see any behind the scenes or sneak peeks of upcoming projects and videos, then be sure to be following me on my Instagram account. And yeah, I think that's about it. Thank you for watching and I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers.